7 years since your first book, four hugely successful books. How are you feeling right now?
It feels very nice, particularly because The High Performance Entrepreneur, it was a very important book for me because I wanted to write a book for would-be entrepreneurs so that everybody is not going after a job and people create jobs for others. And then before you know, 7 years have gone by and I now realize that it's not just important to build startups, it's important to build companies that will scale. India needs companies and organizations and institutions that would scale. And that really gave me the idea of writing The Elephant Catchers.
What is at the heart of The Elephant Catchers?
Expertise, as it says. It goes back to my early childhood experience in remote parts of India. And I watched villagers who would routinely go after, small animals. But I have also seen people who actually trap elephants. Elephant catching requires expertise, determination, stealth, patience, and a lot of other things.
Now give me the analogy. The elephant catchers, the rabbit catchers, the corporate world.
You know, life is all about scale. If you are not continuously scaling, then you are stalling. And that's the first sign of decay. And the rules that brought you here will not take you there. If you look at the purpose of business, what we need to think about is, will the organizations that we create achieve critical mass, make the right impact, and ideally survive us? So one is impact, the other is creating a legacy that survives you. These require a fresh look at the idea of scale. In the context of India today, because we are a G20 country and we want to be a G8 country by 2020. It means our professionals must scale. It means our educational institutions must scale. It means our government must scale. I'm not saying here that this is the ultimate book on scaling, but this is real. This is based on building Mindtree and based on my understanding of other organizations. I started my life as a professional, had one failed startup when I was 28 and talk about that in the book briefly. Ran that company for 3 years and then folded up, came back as a professional to the industry and started Mindtree along with co-founders when I was 42. The first phase was in building the foundation, taking the company public. The second phase was a phase of scaling. How do you scale the intellect, the reputation, people, leaders? Then I said, look, this is not just a Mindtree imperative. It's also an imperative for anybody with ambition in a personal sense. I also from the beginning thought that I have the responsibility to package the intellectual lessons and give it away to the world so that people go on to build companies more memorable than Mindtree, more successful than Mindtree. I told myself that I must be the journal keeper. So if you come to my study, I have all the notebooks. There is something very organic about writing on a piece of paper. And, when you go back in time and absentmindedly you flip through the pages of a notebook, a lot comes alive, which doesn't always happen on a glittering computer screen.
The importance of people in all your books is very obvious. You value human capital. Scaling comes at a cost.
Uncontrolled scaling comes at a cost. And scale managed well can mean bigger job opportunities, bigger promotion avenues, bigger compensation. So it can do a lot of good to your people.
What does Subroto Bagchi want to leave behind at the end of the day?
I want to leave behind an intellectual legacy. I want to humanize the world of business. And I want the people who will come after me to look at business as a very valuable thing the society can do. I think the days are here that a country will be respected if it produces great professionals.
Why did you want to write this book? Why now?
There is a book inside of you and the book will come out when it wants to come out. That's how it works.
It's a classic Subroto brand of humor. Writing business books is a serious business. Why is this element so important?
You know, it's very important because life is difficult. Okay, so people don't want to be bored to death.
Okay? That is true.
And if you're not enjoying reading my book, will you ever, pause to take the lesson?
You write extensively about your experiences in the corporate world. Yet you call yourself a mere practitioner. not a management guru. I think your readers disagree. The word guru pops up everywhere.
Well, that's very nice of you to say that, but I don't want to be cliched and I don't want to be seen as a guru. I think I'm a practitioner. That's what I am. You know, I'm not a businessman in the truest sense. I didn't come from a business family. I started my life as a professional.
The words that are thrown up by your readers are inspiring, encouraging, motivating. That is guru stuff.
Well, thank you so much. What can I say?
There's no denying your books make an impact on the minds of the young. Are you happy with what your books have done?
You know, more than anything else, what makes me really delighted is most of the books have been translated into original languages. So which means that it is not just the mainstream English-speaking, city-bred people for whom these books have an appeal.
When you talk of scale, from a little company to one that has 12,000 plus employees, is there something that you tell yourself every day as you step into this office?
I don't want to leave behind the thought that every morning I'm, you know, hugely optimistic and there is sun rising in the east and rainbows and, you know, butterflies and everything. That days I must tell you that I feel really awful. But when the car turns into Mindtree, everything changes.
Are there any manuscripts in your drawer as we speak?
Not in terms of a business book. You will see something come out, but it is not a management book per se.
With every book that you bring out, how do you better the previous one?
I relate to my books the way that parents relate to children. So, as you're having another baby, you're not trying to better. You just have one more baby. All the babies are so special.
Every book has birthing pangs.
This book was interesting because I was working with a new editor. Poulomi Chatterjee of Hachette has never done a business book before. And she has done fiction for celebrated authors. So I was really a nervous wreck. You know, she was like the sports coach who would want you to run after you're completely crashing down. So, but in the end, it worked out pretty well. And hopefully, Poulomi will do more business books, though I may not write fiction.
Thank you, Subroto.
Thank you, Vinita.
The book is set to release on August 24th. All the best.
Thank you.
Wishing you success.
Thank you so much.